Oh, yeah. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Beauty as Fast TV. We have with here two honorable, wonderful guests, Mr. C.K. Kumarwell of Groom India, that is the owner of several brands, including the natural salons and the Diva and, you know, Enable, so many concepts and in terms of beauty service industry, and then Academy, which has been launched and announced and launched recently, which is the big college that you have launched, and your commitment to women entrepreneurship. So in these times of COVID, we are grateful that we can meet online and, you know, we can talk about our businesses and at least dwell upon them. And also with us, a person very close to my heart, Sheila Iyer. She is the veteran journalist, the most respectable observer of the beauty and wellness industry, a person who has been responsible and standing behind brands for years. So welcome, Sheila ji, and welcome.
Thank you.
So I will start with a few questions first and then hand it over to Sheila ji. Mr. Kumarwell, we are talking about this huge, you know, 400 crore or more, you know, that brand that you have created over the past couple of decades. And amazing kind of roller coaster ride it has been. And we want to really, really understand that in these times of COVID, how have these, you know, collaborations been sustained? What are you doing? Yeah, we see you so active and always inspiring online and offline. So we'd like to hear especially about the COVID times.
Thank you so much, Ritu, and thank you so much, Sheila, for the wonderful opportunity to connect with the salon fraternity. I love this because that fraternity only has given me an identity. So to that extent, it's very special to connecting with the salon fraternity and sharing the knowledge and we have learned. I believe knowledge and wealth needs to be shared. If it is accumulated, it will stink.
Right.
So I'm very, very keen on sharing the knowledge and the wealth as we go along in this journey called life. And Corona has come as a great reminder for all of us. I think each one of us have got an individual responsibility. We also have a collective responsibility. So long we have been thinking of, I should do well, my salon should do well. Today we need to think, I should do well, my salon should do well, my competitor should do well, my industry should do well, my country should do well, the world should do well.
Yes.
I think that's how we should now start thinking. And that's what the Corona message to all of us. When our mind is weak, the situation will look like a problem. When our mind is normal, same situation will look like a challenge. When your mind is strong, same situation will look like an opportunity. So Corona is a great opportunity which has come in front of us.
Yes.
Fast forward 18 months from here, and that is 2021 December.
Sure.
And if you look back, 70% of the people will say, hey, what can I do? Corona has come.
Yeah.
My life is now haywire. Before that, it was going nicely. My business has gone for a toss.
Yes.
The government did not help. The competition has become very aggressive. The customers have changed a lot. And I have been in this thing. Otherwise, my life was good. My problem is only Corona. The 30% of the people will say, hey, I am now doing extremely well because of Corona. Because of Corona, I have changed everything. I have changed what all I can and corrected a few things, unlearned certain things. And relearned certain things. And today my cost has come down. My output has gone up. And thanks to Corona. The question in front of you is, are we going to be in the 30% or are we going to be in the 70%?
Right.
Imagine you are going in a forest and suddenly one lion comes in front of you, you have a problem. Imagine you are going in the forest and the same lion comes in front of you. This time you have an AK-47 in your hand. Now lion has a problem. Lion is the Corona, and how you are getting yourself ready is the AK-47.
So
and
what's the AK-47 that we have at natural salon? for the partner.
AK-47, AK-47, I tell all the people is there is only one skill which is required, which is going to be very critical in the post-corona scenario.
Yes.
Which is reinvent.
Okay.
Reinvent physically, reinvent mentally, reinvent financially, and yes, reinvent business models. Before corona, customer used to select a salon based on the brand name, based on the interiors, based on the staff,
right,
based on the product what is used, based on the price, based on the offers, and based on whether it is near to my salon. Okay. Today, all these seven factors are useless. The only factor the customer is going to select a salon in a post-corona scenario, okay, is it safe? Is it hygienic? Is it clean? That's what the customer is going to be looking for. If you are able to comply to that in full, the customer will come and flock in our salon. And that's what I want to leave it as a first thought.
Okay. So so how is, as a group, how are you like geared for this as the natural salon group, including the franchises?
I think the entire industry is working together.
Yes.
I think I should say thank you to Enrich Salons. I should say thank you to YLG Salons. We are all working together.
Sure.
So that each one of us can put the hygiene standard up.
Sure.
Because any one salon which is making a mistake is going to affect the entire salon. It is not my naturals or my brand. That is the scenario. And all the industry, the leaders are taking the torch bearers and they are taking it forward. The Beauty Sector Skill Council has come out with a new protocol, which is WHO compliant. And also the L'Oreal's and the Wella's and the Schwarzkopf of the world are bringing the world knowledge to us and telling us how China is, what you call, work China salon market is after the COVID, this thing, how are they requiring and what are the precautions they are taking. So all of us are now working together and we are putting the best practice. I think that's wonderful.
Okay.
I'm very happy for it.
Fantastic. We would also now quickly, if you could tell us about the Beauty and Wellness College that has been launched. And we always know, we of course know that, you know, Academy has always been and the backbone of the entire natural structure, and now you're taking it forward in the form of a college. So we really want to understand if you what's happening there, and if you can detail as to what the vision is, etc.
No, the vision is very simple. If you have to grow the business today, interior decorating is available. The place is available. Then the products are available. Investors, banks are now ready to fund the business. So many entrepreneurs are available to drive the business. The biggest challenge is, where do I go get good quality trained staff? And that is not available in plenty. And so I thought, so long we have been looking at salon as an opportunity, only to look at what is the adjacent opportunity for us. And that is when we saw the possibility and the need for creating. Earlier, this business is only apprenticed. There is no auto driving school. Auto driver will get apprenticed.
Right.
Same way, the salon people also will get apprenticed only. They will work in a barber shop or in a beauty parlor, work for 6 months to a year. They learn the trick of the trade and they go somewhere else and get a job, or they start their own salon. There is no formal way of learning this business. And after the, 2010 or something, Habib and few of the people have started the kind of the school in a this thing. But I always dream big. My job is to dream big. I always say that dream big, start small and keep moving. And that's my formula for life. And I said, hey, here is a great opportunity in front of us. Can we create a beauty and wellness college? And that's the need of the hour at this point of time, because people are now going to pay money and going to learn the skill, because this is now considered as a lifestyle industry.
Right.
Rewind 20 years before, this industry was considered to be a taboo industry. Right. There was an interesting anecdote which I want to share, which happened few months before I walked into one of our salon. The receptionist did not recognize me. I felt happy and unhappy. Happy because I thought, okay, I've become so big. Unhappy because the person did not recognize. I met the second person. She also did not recognize. So this time I started a little more jittery. And then I met the third person. And luckily that person recognized me. He said, come in and please take your seat. Okay. Thank God, I said. And she said, are you C.K. Kumaravel? I said, yes, boss. Appa, thank God. He now knows me. I said, I wanted to come and thank you, he said. I thought maybe the franchisee has given him a salary raise or some training my training team has given. I asked for what? He said, I am in this industry for 14 years. And 4 years I worked in some other salon, last 10 years in naturals. Before you had come into this business is considered to be a taboo business. Right. And the hairdressers are not respected in the society. Today we are no more hairdressers. We are hairstylists, senior stylists, style directors. And the society starts respecting us very differently. For that, thank you, he said. I said, wow, that I have never thought that unknowingly I have made an impact converting a taboo industry to a lifestyle industry. So many franchisees, educated people, and so many people have today come to this industry. I think that's a good thing which is happening to the industry because everybody together are creating it. So that's when I realized that need for, that is the my trigger for the training. I said, I want to now put it big and tell the world, I have to put my dream up there. The world will conspire with me and make my dream come true. And that's how my whole journey is. So that's exactly is the idea of the beauty and wellness college.
The college will be offered.
One day, every district should have a beauty and wellness college in this country. That's okay, it. There should be every kind of, every state should have a beauty and wellness university. And that's how much the dream should be. And we will see it, we will, in our own eyes.
Okay, so the college has, it will be offering degrees or as opposed to...
Correct. Yes. Okay. It will be offering, because only when a degree is there somewhere, people are attached to that college degree.
Right.
And that is where they get little bit of a more respect. So we need to play to the society's rule also, and we also should change the rules.
Right.
I think we should play simultaneously. Just okay. Changing the rule alone will not work. We should comply and then change.
Okay. Thank you so much. So with that, I will take it over to Sheila ji to fire her questions to you. Yes, Sheila ji.
Thank you, Ritu. And
thank you,
very good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
You're always been very close to the salon industry. So all parts of the salon industry has always interested you. I've seen you do various things in this industry. But you were the first to take over a company called Vyomo, which was a home services industry. I mean, the home services part of the business. And after acquiring it, you changed it to, you called it Naturals at Home, which was brilliant. Now, what is the status and where do you see this home services?
So, if I have to say that one thing I can pride of myself is I have made more mistakes than anybody else in this business. And that is what is my plus point. Okay. Among the various businesses I did, I introduced Beauty on Wheels way back in 2002. Made hazard mistakes. And every time I make a mistake, I correct it and keep on doing that. And in my mind, Vyoma is one of the mistakes I have done. I have acquired without understanding the turf of the market and this thing well. I went on to, I liked the entrepreneurs. When I am very intuitive. When I like a person, I want to sign a deal with them. So I like the entrepreneurs and I did a deal with them. But somehow when we realize that when we get into the market, this is not working out very well in the this thing, especially making it naturals at home. I became a competitor to my own franchises and it has become a double challenge for me. And the market in South also is not very home service friendly because there is a branded salon at every nook and corner of the house and at a very reachable place. So the market need for a home salon also is become very less. That is when we have worked on it and we dropped it. But having said that, post-corona is a new opportunity. Today I'm going to revisit that.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to revisit and see how much is the home service opportunity today. I think there is a great opportunity in the post-corona scenario because I'm not wanting to call it a social distancing. It is not, in my mind, it is not social distancing because we are, corona time, we are socially more connected to everybody than any other time. So it is a physical distancing, which is the need of the hour. In a need where physical distancing is that, I think the home service will again play a very important role. I am revisiting that business model at this point of time. That is what I said, reinvent. The illiterate, Alvin Toffler says so beautifully, he says, the illiterates of the 21st century are not the ones who cannot read and write. The illiterates of the 21st century are the ones who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. We have to unlearn a lot of things. We have to relearn a lot of things. I am going to relearn naturals at home and come back to the home service business again.
So it's going to be future shock or future pleasant surprise.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, so now one other aspect that, one other area that you ventured into or you're venturing into is private label. You came up, this is not new for you. You've always been doing products and you've always had interest in products. So this private label is an area that you have got into, I think, once again, kind of. So what is it this time, what you will do differently?
Well, there are two things which is very different at this point of time. One is I have got 650 salons. My in-house consumption itself is significant for us to launch a brand. And the second most important thing is the online, which is business which has come recently. So any product which you make very well and it is a brand is today can be sold in the Nykaa.coms, the Amazon.coms and so many other things which has come into the picture. So that gives us an additional opportunity. I am always looking at adjacent opportunity to my business. See, today I don't want to really diversify. I want to remain only in the beauty and wellness industry. In that, I am looking at adjacent opportunity. Because if I go to a new field, then there will be a lot of learnings I have to go through and my probability of success reduces significantly. If I am operating on the adjacent opportunity, which is what is the training center all about, which is what is the product business all about, which is what is the at-home business all about. So these adjacent opportunity, because we know a lot of things and we are going to tweak a little. And that kind of business model, that is why we have a pastry salon, we have a Diva, we have a Naturals, all those things are all the same, this thing, the packaged differently and doing that. So in that only, my probability of success is very high. Naturals Ayur is also one such thing. And that's how I'm looking at this.
So this private label, will you be taking it only from the salons or you're planning to get, to make it available throughout your research?
No, it will be available primarily in the salon to as a test marketing. As a test market, it will be done in the salon. Once the test marketing is over, it will go to online and also go to modern trades. Because India is a large opportunity and I think there is a need for a good quality product at an affordable price. My role model, as you all many know, it is Anita Roddick, the owner of the Body Shop International. I came into salon business only because of her, understanding her franchise business and things like that. And I always dreamt of creating an Indian body shop. And I thought body shop in India is unaffordable and is only catering to the niche segment. And India lives at different level. I wanted to create an Indian body shop, a high quality, affordable Indian products. And that's what I want to create. And that's what is the products business all about.
So affordable is your mantra from when? Or it's always been your mantra?
No, affordable is what we have heard from my father from the day in which we started business. My father's primary business was to buy pharma products in bulk and put it in small packets and distribute to medical shops. He did various businesses. One day he was traveling to Singapore to attend an exhibition and he was carrying a suitcase. In this suitcase was a Tata bottle shampoo. Mm. Fortunately for us and unfortunately for him, the bottle broke. Mm. And I told you he bought pharma products in bulk and put it in small packets. Here he thought, can I also make shampoo in small packets instead of breaking the bottles? And that is how he made his own machines. He formulated the shampoo. He packed India's first sachet shampoo and called it Velvet and launched it to the market. Last decade, India Today came out with an article about 50 revolutions which changed India after independence. And my father's sachet innovation was number 8 in that. That was one of the most gratifying moments for us. What he said was very significant. He said, what the rich person is able to enjoy, the poor person should be able to afford. That was the philosophy with which he launched the sachet shampoo. So our thought process of value and reaching the large number of people affordable is always there ingrained in us right from our childhood by my father.
This one very unusual marriage with a CAD center. So very unusual partner. So how did this come about and what was the idea behind this?
It's extraordinary situations requires extraordinary decision making. I was crossing that 500 salon number, but me as an entrepreneur, always the business rises either to the capability or to the incapability of the entrepreneur. Till 500, I was in control. After 500, my incapability came into the picture. Because that is when I realized that, boss, this is business has to grow, means I now need to partner with somebody who, complements my weakness. Otherwise, my weakness will come into the picture. I am a very intuitive thinker. I am a very creative thinker. I am a risk taker. But on the contrary, I am not a detailed person. I am not a structured person. I am not a system process person. So the business after 500 to 3000 can be done only by systems and process. So I wanted somebody who can do that. And that is when I found CAD Center. And I also wanted somebody who will be franchise friendly. If they are the only successful franchise company in an education business, which was created by NIIT and Apple, but they are being able to successfully run that business. I used to be a speaker in their conference. And that is when I saw a very happy set of franchises. I said, if we have to scale from here to here, there, can you help me? And that is what they were also looking for, a person, because their education business was not scaling up at this point, and they were looking at another opportunity. And it is a win-win deal for both the people. I call it the 1+1=11 effect. Normally, 1+1 is not equal to 2. It will be 3 and multiples of 3. In this case, between CAD and naturals, it's a 1+1=11. And that's what we could create in that. I play to my strength and they play to their strength.
So what are we going to see exciting now from you?
I think the whole life is going to be, for a moment, when the corona struck, believe me, the first 1 week I was really challenged. I was not ready for this kind of shock. I was thinking life was good, so I need to go and take care of the society. That's when I ventured into politics and all those things I was doing. The corona has brought me back to the business. And I am going to be here for some more time and ensure that the business is steady, business is going to the next level. At this point, what we pride ourselves as a southern wonder, in the next 3 years will become a national wonder. And soon it will become an international wonder. My dream is to make naturals as the number one salon chain of the world. God willing, inshallah, that dream also will come to pass.
How did you manage this 200 in 2020? This figure is just perfect for you. I think 20 years or two. How have you managed that? The 20 years and 2020.
Yeah. Life is not what happens to you. Life is how you respond to what happens to you. And I've been, whatever opportunity comes in front of me, I used to convert them. Problems are converted to opportunities. Opportunities are converted to bigger opportunities. And that's how I have built my business. And some things happen, and to say thank you very much for that.
Ritu?
Yeah.
I think I'm done with him.
We'll never be done with
him. Yeah, we can never be done with
him. So, Mr. Kumar, that's very interesting. In fact, I was just wondering while Sheilaji was talking that, what kind of format do you think? Like, you have so many beautiful formats. Enable is so interesting. Like, nobody has thought about it before. And then there is Naturals Ayur, which I'm very excited about because I feel that that's the need of the hour. Wellness is going to go, through the roof now that we realize that being, immune and having strong system and physically and mentally being strong is so important. And Ayurveda is all about that. So which format do you think is going to grow faster if you have to choose one or two of your various formats?
No, Naturals Ayur is a very close to the heart format.
Yes.
I don't see scale coming there, but something you feel very nice about yourself.
Yeah.
I think that is for me is Naturals Enable. Naturals Enable for me is that kind of close to the heart format, where you feel that you can the people who are working there are physically challenged people. There are visually challenged reflexologists. There is a speech impaired person. There is an orthopedic impaired person. There is a transgender. All the people working together. I think world itself is it's an inclusive India. It's an inclusive world. We need to include everybody and live our life. I think that's a showcase we are doing. But we are going to expand that model only in malls, because there is a criteria which is required for handling the physically challenged person. On a normal high street, it is not available, or it is available at a much higher cost. So I am doing the enable brand only in the malls. Okay. When it comes to naturals, Ayur, it's a concept which is created more for international. When I wanted to take naturals to the international market, I said, hey, America and London doesn't require one more naturals. So they need something different. What can I do different? That is when we thought we should put Ayur together and take the market there. So I think it will take another 1 year or so for it to really see how the market, because the world has to open up. We are all coming from the shock of the COVID. Yes. Though there is a great opportunity, I think we need to be watchful in our steps in the international market. That's yes. What is the Ayur for me. But I am always, Indian by heart. And I think India is the great opportunity. So naturals, to me, is the biggest and the best opportunity, because it's an opportunity to create women entrepreneurs. It's an opportunity to create jobs. It's an opportunity to organize a taboo industry to a lifestyle industry.
Yeah.
And to me, there is a multiple this thing what naturals gives me. That's why we have named our company as Groom India, which means the Indians, if they look good, they will feel good. If they feel good, they will perform good. If they perform good, again, they will look good. That's why we call the Groom India. All the Indians should look good. It is not only the people in Delhi and Bombay. It is India lives everywhere and different class. I think grooming should reach everyone. And that's what is our mission.
Yeah. Women entrepreneurs, going back to your original something that is a line that you have lived and you have executed in your business on creating women entrepreneurs, and I would like to hear some, if you, over the years, what are some of the key insights you've got, once you've got, you've had this motivation of creating women entrepreneurs to your business.
Yeah, the motivation for women entrepreneurs, it started off with my mother, and when I was 13, and my eldest brother was 25, and there were four siblings in between. Total, we are six of us, and my father died. And next day morning, my mother calls all six of us, and she tells all of us that from today, I'm going to be your father and mother. As a 13-year-old kid, I did not even understand the grasp what she is trying to say. But for the next 35 years, she lived exactly that. And she is our biggest inspiration. From a 9th class dropout person with a 2.5 lakh debt in 1979, which is today more close to 25 crores plus. Six children, nobody is married. To anchor them, not only make them safe, also to make them successful. She ran a school, she ran an agriculture, she ran an industry, she ran bakery, she ran a tailoring, she sang, she danced, she lived a complete life. Looking at her is a great inspiration. We did not even need to go anywhere else. But when we go out and we meet some extraordinarily talented, extraordinarily, advantageous women, but they don't really take their life in hand and they play a secondary fiddle. And when we see that happening, time and again, I used to get very angry. And I said, if this energy is channelized, see what difference can it make. The society is like a bird. The men and women are its two wings. The bird cannot fly with one wing. And India, I see so many talented women, and channelizing their energy and channelizing their this thing, potential, and channelizing their dream is the naturals business. And that is where Veena said, Veena's refusal to continue as a housewife was the beginning of the brand Naturals. So, and that's how I was so fascinated by women, the women power. And women, all they need is something. They need a little bit of a framework and a push. After that, they are so disciplined, they are so dedicated, they are so detailed. Nothing will shake them, and they are like that. Whereas men are greedy. Had my business being a men business, men franchise network, by now it would have collapsed. Because while men are very industrious and risk-taking, they are also very greedy and ambitious. And greed comes. When the greed comes into the picture, they will say, why I should be part of this system? I don't know everything. I can do myself. All those tamashas will come. Whereas women are very comfortable to work in a framework, to work in a system. And that is where I feel women are very good, not only for Naturals Ka franchise, not only for salon franchise, for any franchise business, women are the best partners.
That's fantastic. How are your plans for joining politics going now?
Yeah, politics is politics is very this thing for 350 years.
Yeah.
The Mughals and the British have looted us.
Yes.
And for the next 73 years, it is the turn of the local people.
Mm.
It is not the violence of the bad people which destroy the society. It is the silence of the good people.
Sure.
So it is the turn of all. Gandhi was pushed out of the train in South Africa. He got angry and he channelized his anger. So we are now living in a free India. Anger, when channelized, becomes a powerful force. Anger, if not channelized, will become a frustration and eventually will become negative. I want to, I want to see this thing. So people in politics, the decision makers, we are thinking this, that. Finally, all the decisions are taken by them. How much tax to pay, which god to pray, what dress to wear, how we can travel, which language to study, all those things are decided by them. We think politicians are jokers. No, they are actually the smartest people. But the problem is the good people and smart people are staying away, leaving the turf to somebody else. That is when I said all good people and smart people, for your own goodness and for the benefit of the children, your own children, come and join politics. Politics is not a bad place. It is now filled by bad people. It is because good people are staying away. The solution is good people have to join. It is not one person joining. We need to join together. We need to get angry. We need to get angry together. And that is when our anger can be channelized. That is when we can, it's a mandate and a responsibility for us to gift our next generation a safe India and a beautiful India. For that, we need to compromise a bit, stretch a bit, work a little harder, and we also need to think of the society. We keep on thinking and adding one more zero, one more zero, one more zero is not going to work. When Corona is again a reminder for all of us, we have an individual responsibility, we have a collective responsibility. Let us do that. Let us do with the home responsibility. Let us also go to society responsibility. Only like that we can create a vibrant democracy.
Fantastic. So we would love to be to have you representing the industry in the parliament very soon.
I think all of us.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. I'm only saying all good people.
Yes, all good people.
Okay, yes. Okay. I can take the leadership. I can be the first one. But yes. I am standing in a bus stand wanting to, everybody are rushing and getting in. I am standing in queue. Okay. If you people don't come and join the queue, I have two options. One, to go home, or I also join the crowd. I don't want to join the crowd. I want more and more people. That's why I'm begging, I'm requesting, I'm pleading with all good people and all the, the nice people. Telling them, boss, today women are called a minority in this country. It is a gross injustice happening in front of you. How can we allow that to happen? Can we not create and fight that out? And that's exactly what I want to do that. And I think we all need to do that. That's why I always used to say, together, let us build a beautiful India.
Sure. Fantastic. So on that positive note, anything, Sheila, do you want to add?
No, nothing else.
During,
leave it for the next time.
Yeah. Reinvent. Let's all together pass this COVID and make the individual proud and also collectively India proud and the world proud.
Thank you, Sheila.
It's wonderful.
Safe journey ahead, and let's all meet, at a conference in a real time also, at a real space.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you, Sheila ji, joining us, and those lovely questions. You know, with so much knowledge going out to the industry today. Thank you, and all the best. Have a great day.
Thank you. Bye.